place over our shoulders just a few moments ago, and we can tell you it was a few moments ago, because since then, Martin Truex Jr. has made his way over here to join us 2 weeks in a row. We get to talk to you. You're just sort of taking all the points, saying, hey, the rest of you guys don't get any. I'm going
to
take
them all. Man, am I glad to see you guys.
Yes.
Oh, man, yeah, unbelievable. What a night. Unbelievable. You know, I knew we were going to be good coming into the race, but I didn't know how good. So to be able to drive up to the front there, that first stage, and take the lead and win the first stage, I was like, all right, we got something here. If we can just keep up with the racetrack, keep working on it. And then it was kind of up and down from there. So hats off to all the guys in the pits, and Cole and James for continuing to work with me and dial it in. And, yeah. Spin and win. How about that?
Spin and win. That was not your only close call. There were other close calls out there. I mean, we saw you pass. I think Dylan was on your inside. You go around him. Lap traffic. How was lap traffic in this race? I mean, you guys were catching them. High side, low side. And there were times it seemed like you guys, especially you and Kyle and Denny and a couple other ones, were 15 mile an hour faster than anybody else out there.
Well, I don't know, at times it felt, on those long runs, man, it feels like you're crawling here. You know how it used to be. I mean, it was so slick out there tonight. Yeah. But it was close. The lap cars, were difficult. You had to pick like last week. Yes. You had to commit to a lane before you got to them, and you just hoped that you picked the right one, you know. And there was one or two times where I committed to a lane, and then they turned down in front of me or slid up in front of me, and I was like, oh, my God, you know. And it's hard to slow down getting into corners with as slick it is in old tires with the brakes hot and everything else. So, it was tough to manage, but it was tough on everyone. And, everybody, I thought, did a good job tonight of, giving room and being respectful. And Kyle and I were able to race it out through traffic here pretty good at the end.
I must say, this champagne cologne you're wearing the last couple of weeks is nice, isn't it?
It's a mixture of Monster and Gatorade, I think. It smells like cotton candy. It's kind of funny, but it's kind of gross, but it's worth it.
How about racing a teammate? Talk to us about that, Mark. I mean, especially on a short track where you have to give it everything, and, you know, sometimes you have to put a fender to them, but although y'all race very clean, but getting in situations like this.
Yeah, I mean, it's, Kyle and I have raced for a long time together, since we came into the Busch Series together, same with Denny. Eric a couple years. So we just have a great, really good group of drivers. We all get along. We all have a lot of respect for each other, what we've done, what we're doing now. And the ultimate goal is to have all our teams run good, have them all run up front. We share everything. We try to help each other. And, I really enjoy racing with those guys. So we had to run hard against them tonight. The last run, we had to pass 11. He gave us some room and then had to pass the 18. He got him into me off of two there. I kind of cleared him and parked it a little bit so he wouldn't do the crossover. I tried to stay on the bottom, and he bumped into me. But it was all good. It was a lot of fun. And, big day for the company, finishing 1-2-3-4.
Yeah, 1-2-3-4, not happened at Gibbs Racing before. And you say a big day for the company. Eric Jones slides in fourth there. Big day for Eric Jones. You talk about sharing that information. Will there come a time as we get down to 1-2-3-4 and all you guys may be headed to Miami that we're not going to share as much?
Honestly, I don't know. I don't think so. I don't know how you can keep secrets.
Yeah.
I mean, everything they do is on a computer and everybody has the password.
Yeah.
It goes into a system. And so I don't know. I mean, I guess there's maybe a chance that you could hide some things here and there, but all our cars are built together. The guys at the shop do a great job of that, keeping everybody's cars the same. And, we make little decisions here and there, like maybe I want this a little different, maybe I want that a little bit different, but there is no secret. So I think we're stronger as a group. And I think if we can continue to do our thing, we can all get to Homestead.
Martin, I think this is your first time winning back-to-back races in the same season. Getting that done, I think I just heard that you got the most wins over the last three seasons. You talk about this rivalry with Kyle Busch. So talk to us about what this is like. What's this feeling, man? I mean, you have to be on top of the world right now.
Yeah, I mean, like last week, I like these little nuggets, It's just, it's just unbelievable to be part of this, And, since 2015, it's just been a joyride. It's been a dream. It's not been easy. It's been hard work. But it's nice when your hard work gets rewarded. There was plenty of years when our hard work didn't get rewarded. So, I'm just thankful. I mean, there's so many people that are responsible for this, from guys at the shop to, Johnny Morris, as we mentioned last weekend, sticking behind me, and sponsors like Auto Owners and, in Toyota. I've been with Toyota a lot of years now, and they've always been behind me since I've been there. So it takes an army of people to do this, and just feel really fortunate to have a great group surrounding us on this 19 team, and also you know, collectively at Joe Gibbs Racing.
You know, you come over here and the first thing you say was, I'm still as excited this week as I was last week. And you don't seem to take this for granted, that these wins, they're not just going to come. They're hard fought, each one of them. And I think that speaks volumes for you. Explain to these people out here how hard it is to win a cup race.
Well, I mean, I won my first one in 07. I didn't win my second one until 2012. So that's how hard it is. And I was with good teams. They weren't great teams. They weren't winning a lot of races. And you know, certainly we were in position to win a few along the way. But, you know, those things didn't materialize. And it was so frustrating. But you just had to keep digging. You had to keep working hard and keep the faith and keep believing. And, you know, got through that, all that. And the couple years at MWR had pretty decent years. But we only won one race. And then got together with Furniture Row and with Cole. And that was when Cole became the crew chief. It was just like somebody lit a fire under both our butts, you know. And ever since, it's been amazing. So you guys know it's a lot about – this sport's a lot about people. It's about relationships and believing in one another and the whole team pulling in the same direction. And we've just had that for the last, you know, 5 years. It's been great.
When do y'all have y'all's team meeting?
Tomorrow, Monday.
Okay.
Monday.
You just need to tell Denny that you drive the 19 because it slipped that he said that 78 car was fast again.
Oh,
so you just need to make sure that he knows it.
My spotter's even slipped a couple times. He's like, stage win, blah, 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 19, or like new leader, 19.
It was so cool, man. It was so cool. Congratulations.
Well, yep, yeah. And here's something else you've waited a long time to hear. You are a multiple short track winner.
Yeah.
Yeah, that feels good.
That feels good.
It feels really good. You know, we'd led so many laps here in so many races, and we just kind of paid our dues, I guess, you know, and now the last two things have rolled our way. So, yeah, sometimes, you know, those heartbreakers, I guess you get rewarded in the end.
Well, you know where to find us next Sunday, right?
Yeah.
I know exactly where you'll be. I sure do hope I can do it.
Oh, my goodness. Wouldn't that be incredible?
Yeah. Last year was a bummer, so
yeah,
we'll see.
All right. Martin Truex Jr., back-to-back wins in the playoffs, back-to-back wins here at Richmond.